Guys, welcome back to the channel. Thanks very much for joining us again. We have a short video demonstration for you today that will show you how to change pages to scroll on your website in Wix. So how to make a scrolling page on Wix, basically. So the way that Wix works is that it does this for us automatically now. It's not like a Word package where I can just click in an area around here and press enter on the keyboard until a new space appears. We do have to add a section or something to the page in order for it to become a scrolling page. So as you can see here, if I give you a quick preview of it, I've just got a typical landing page with a welcome sign on it. And when I scroll the mouse wheel up and down, I can see the header and the footer, and that's it. So to make this into a scrolling page, you would need to go to the top left-hand corner here and hit the Add Elements button. That's one way of going about it, and you'll see that you've got a menu here then of many things that you can add to it. So for example, you know, we could add an image or a button or whatever and kind of drag that into place. If we also then, the areas of these pages in Wix are referred to as sections. And as you can see, when I'm hovering to the top of the section and the bottom of it, this little box here with the desert image in the background, you can see that I can add a section as well. So adding elements to a section, or adding a section, a new section in and of itself, will automatically adjust the size of the page, as I'll show you in a second. So if I add a section, you can see that I'm being prompted here to choose a section and drop it anywhere on the page. Obviously I want it above my footer and below my header and below this welcome box. So typically you drop it in that space there. And you can see now we've got kind of preset section types then, I guess, depending on what you want. If you can't see exactly what you want to add in this list, then just look for something that visually looks like what you want, and then those are that's closest to it, and then drag that in and modify it till it looks like what you want, if that makes sense, you know. So always use a template to get to what you want to quicker. If you do want to make one from scratch, you can add a blank section there at the very top. So that'll just give you literally a blank box, which is denoted as a new section. So if we want to add maybe our story after the welcome, I literally just single left click it and drag it into that area, drop it there. And you can see now that it's automatically added this new section and made our website into a scrolling page. So if I give you a preview, you can see that it now opens like that. And then when I scroll with the mouse wheel, or I can use the slider bar at the right hand side, up and down, it now scrolls. So if I go back, and just to show you again, you can use the Add Section button up here underneath the Add Elements button, or go down and add that section manually like that. If I add a couple more, typically something like contacts you'd add in there. And then maybe if I add one more with that button, maybe some events that we've got going on as well. And obviously you can drag and drop these, you know, if you left click and hold it and then take the object to the kind of borders of the screen up and down, you can scroll up and down and kind of drop it in and amongst other sections as well that already exists. So if I now give that a second to add events to my page, and as you see in a second when I preview it, that will now scroll as one long page. Okay, so if I give you a preview, give it a second, and there you go. So you've got this longer scrolling page that we've just created. Okay, so you can see that it does it automatically for you. Obviously then, if you want to kind of modify the look of them, you can click and drag the section borders. So when you hover over the border of the section, you can see that I get this up and down arrow, and that will allow you to adjust the height of a section. Okay, so you can make it a little bit smaller, but obviously that's going to affect the section above it as well. Okay, so for example, if I drag this section down, you can see that I can now see more of the desert image and less of this one as well. Okay, and that concludes our video tutorial. If you need professional one-on-one custom support from Wix experts, then click the link in the description below. Even if you need a complete rebuild or redesign of your site, the support team of Wix web developers is here to help you. If you find this video useful, then please make sure to like and subscribe for more website tutorials, as well as comment below if you have any video requests for future videos. Thanks.